Self-Service Disability Compensation Claims Tool at va.gov. Section 2. Add Contentions, also referred to as disabilities. In Section 2, we'll cover how a veteran adds disabilities, or contentions, to the claim and look at the flow of interview questions for veterans filing a new claim for PTSD. As you can see, this is the same Apply for Disabilities Compensation page that we ended on in the Section 1 video, but we've now reached Section 2 of 5. In Section 2, veterans may add disabilities that already have a rating at VA. This section is also where new conditions can be included with claims. Users can choose from the list of their service-connected conditions and add them to their claim to be considered for an increased evaluation. This screen will only appear for veterans who have existing rated conditions and who indicated that an existing condition has gotten worse in Section 1. Please note, the list will only show conditions that have been service-connected, ranging from 0 to 100%. The list will not show conditions not deemed service-connected, nor those pending a decision. As you can see on the screen, our sample veteran has one rated disability, headaches, which has a current rating of 50%. This example of a rated disability has been selected, but each veteran will have the option of selecting their own disabilities when completing the online interview process. After seeing the list of rated conditions, the veteran selects the Continue button. Here, veterans can indicate whether or not they have a new condition they want to add to their claim, and our sample veteran has selected yes. The next screen gives the veteran the opportunity to specify one or more new disabilities, and they can type freely into the entry field. If the veteran doesn't know the name for their condition, they can type in a description to help determine what to select. Our sample veteran has entered both back injury and PTSD as two new disabilities. For each condition, the veteran needs to enter details to explain how the condition is connected to their military service. From these options, they can indicate that the condition was directly related to their time in service, caused by another service-connected condition, was a pre-existing condition that worsened because of service, or was caused by something that happened during VA treatment. Ample space is now available for veterans to input details on related disabilities or secondary conditions in addition to the primary condition. Our sample veteran has specified that their back injury was caused by an injury or exposure during military service, and the veteran can enter a description of this service-connected injury. Newly claimed PTSD-related conditions have a separate series of questions that ask for the type of event, dates, location, and assignment. All answers to PTSD questions are optional, and veterans are provided opportunities to take breaks and connect with the Veteran Crisis Line as needed. After clicking Continue, the next section asks the veteran to specify what type of event contributed to their PTSD. They can select combat, sexual trauma, personal assault, non-combat PTSD other than sexual trauma or personal assault, or a combination of those four options. Our sample veteran has selected combat. Moving forward, the tool asks the veteran optional questions about their combat-related PTSD. The veteran can decide to answer the questions online or fill out and upload VA Form 21-0781. For the purpose of this video, our sample veteran has decided to answer questions online. The tool prompts the veteran to describe any medals or citations they received for the event that triggered their PTSD so VA can better research their claim. Our veteran has left this section blank, indicating they did not receive any medals or citations, or they simply do not want to mention any. Next, the tool prompts the veteran to share when the event happened. Our sample veteran indicates the event occurred on March 3, 1965. The online interview process then asks for details of the particular assignment the veteran held during this time, including the dates they were with this unit. The assignment can include the assigned division, wing, battalion, cavalry, or ship. Our sample veteran left this portion blank. Clicking Continue, the veteran can provide any location details relevant to the event, such as country, state or province, and city. There is also an empty box where the veteran can type in details such as an address or any landmarks. We will specify the event took place in the United States and leave the other fields blank. Next, the form will ask if anyone was injured or killed during the event. We will mark no and proceed. Once again, any veteran going through the form will receive a notice saying they can take a break from the process and reach out to the Veterans Crisis Line if needed. Recounting an event that led or contributed to PTSD can be incredibly difficult, so we want to make sure to remind our veterans of the resources available to help them. This leads to an open box where the veteran can describe the event itself. the veteran can provide as much or as little information as is comfortable. The veteran is now asked if they have another event or situation to share with VA. Our sample veteran has selected no. Before moving on, the veteran is provided with another fillable box where they can share any additional details about the event or their PTSD. Following these PTSD-related questions, the form then asks the veteran if they were ever a prisoner of war, to which our sample veteran has responded no. The next portion gives notice that the veteran may be eligible for additional disability compensation or benefits to help with special claims. It lets them know that the following parts of Section 2 will ask questions to determine eligibility for these additional benefits. If the requirements are met, they will need to download and fill out additional forms to apply. Clicking the Continue button, the veteran moves to a set of questions related to if they need any allowances or adaptive benefits. The first set of questions relates to automobiles and homes. The tool asks if the veteran needs help buying or modifying their home or car as a result of their service-connected conditions. Our sample veteran has selected yes for needing help buying or modifying their home, and no for needing help buying or modifying their car. Moving on with the Continue button, the tool asks the veteran if they are confined to their home or need help with everyday activities as a result of their service-connected disabilities. Our sample veteran has selected yes. Clicking Continue, the veteran can answer if their disability prevents them from holding down a job that they could otherwise do, not including being retired. Our sample veteran has once again selected no and presses the Continue button. Next, the veteran is provided with a summary of additional benefits they have indicated they wish to apply for. Our sample veteran lists the desire for both adapted housing assistance and aid in attendance. When the veteran clicks on the plus sign next to each of these two benefits, the tool will show them which other forms they must complete to apply for these respective benefits. Finally, the veteran sees a list of all conditions being claimed on the application so they can review before moving on to Section 3. As you can see on the screen, our sample veteran has headaches, a back injury, and PTSD related to combat listed as their disabilities. This completes the video tutorial of Section 2 of the Self-Service Benefits Compensation Tool. In Section 3, we'll show how veterans can share evidence to support their claim. The new Self-Service Disability Compensation Tool is located at www.va.gov/disability/how-2-file-claim.